Did you know that with just a few simple adjustments, you can instantly elevate your color grade? I've built what I call the color grading cheat sheet, so make sure you watch till the end because every step builds on the last. This is my golden formula for building a solid foundation in any grade. Don't underestimate it. Once you get this combination right, you're already halfway there. Let me break it down. Exposure adjustments helps redefine luminance, recovers highlights and shadows, and gives you a clean starting point. Contrast then brings out depth, separation, and the natural colors of your scene. It's what defines the overall feel of your image. Then white balance, or color toning as I like to call it, defines the color temperature of the image. Take a look at this example. Starting with the exposure adjustments, assuming you have correctly converted your footage. And here comes the problem. The image looks dull, flat, or overexposed. We need to rebalance the exposure. Use the HDR color wheels. They are my go-to tools because they give clean, surgical control over tonal zones. Just make sure you've set the correct color space before making any changes. If you're new to this, rely on waveform and scopes, or download a free false color monitor to help guide exposure. The goal is simple. Make sure your image's brightness falls into the right tonal zones. Once you get the exposure adjusted, use contrast and pivot together. Contrast increases or decreases separation between shadows and highlights, while pivot shifts where that separation happens. If you're grading in DaVinci wide gamut, start with the default pivot's value of 0.336, then adjust up or down until the image feels balanced. Be careful not to overcrush shadows or blow out highlights. Once contrast is set properly, the true colors begin to emerge. Now, I prefer calling this last item of this formula color toning instead of white balance because white is relative in color grading. Do I want the overall tone to feel warm, neutral, or cool? My go-to tool is the offset wheel with the factor scope for guidance. It lets me push the entire image warmer or cooler with subtle precision. Just remember, once you define your white point, it affects everything downstream. Every color decision you make after this builds on that base tone, so get it right early. Master this formula, and you'll grade faster and spend way less time fixing problems later in the pipeline. Let's jump a little further down the color grading pipeline for a quick moment. One of the most common goals in grading is to create filmic contrast. That soft, organic roll-off in highlights and shadows while keeping midtones rich and dimensional is actually much simpler than it looks. After your creative grade, which I will talk about later in this video, create a new note dedicated to soft clip. The goal is to soften both shadows and highlights as the final polish. In DaVinci Resolve, you'll find soft clip right beside the custom curves controls. Set the histogram to output so you can see what's changing in real time. Low sets the luminance level at which the shadows start to be gently compressed. Low soft controls how compressed you want the shadows to be as you move from 0 to 100, essentially making them softer and bringing back details. The same applies to high and high soft for highlight. By finessing these four controls, you can dial in anything from a faded vintage look to a clean cinematic roll-off. I use this third sheet, masking, more and more in my color grading workflow. When you're working with natural light, it changes constantly, and that often leads to uneven exposure or a lack of visual focus. But here's the fix. In color grading, we can reshape light using masks to subtly redistribute exposure and restore intention to the shot. Create a note before your primary corrections so that this adjustment feels baked in, as if it were part of the original lighting. That way, every adjustment downstream reacts naturally to it. There are three practical ways to use masking. Number one, reshape the light. Go to Windows and pick a mask that fits your scene. Gradient, circular, or custom curve. Slightly lift or lower the gamma in the color wheels to mimic a directional light source. Then adjust softness and distance for a natural fall off. This helps the subjects feel more connected to the light in the scene. Number two, guide the viewer's eyes. Draw a circular or curved mask around your subject. You can either brighten the subject or invert the mask to subtly darken the surroundings. The goal is simple. Guide attention where it matters. Just keep the transition soft so it blends seamlessly into the environment. Number three, balance the frame. When your light ratio feels too harsh, deep shadows pulling the eyes away, use a gradient mask to gently lift those darker areas. This smooths out exposure and makes the overall composition more pleasing. What I love about masking is that it's simple yet incredibly effective. It makes your image feel more intentional. Let's go back up the grading pipeline. After the primary correction, we start shaping colors by making minor color adjustments. I'll show you the solutions to the following common problems. Scenario 1. Washed out colors. One of the biggest questions I get from beginners is, how do I get that filmic saturation? The quick answer is, don't just boost saturation, shape it with luminosity. When you increase global saturation in the color wheels, you're not just enhancing color intensity, you're also altering luminance and contrast. That's why the image can quickly look harsh or plastic. Instead, think of color as three-dimensional: hue, saturation, and luminosity. Pull up your hue versus luminosity curve, or use color slice, and lower the luminosity of overly bright colors towards the midtone area, also known as the hero zone. That shift makes colors feel richer, more grounded, and filmic. Scenario 2, dull colors. Sometimes the opposite happens. The colors feel dead, especially in backlit or overcast scenes. In that case, lift the luminosity of those specific hues to give them energy and brilliance. Watch what happens to these leaves when I raise the luminosity. They instantly come alive against the light. Scenario 3, non-cohesive colors. When colors across your image don't harmonize, everything feels disconnected. For a quick fix, go to hue versus hue. For example, if you're aiming for an orange-teal palette, qualify the warm and cool tones and nudge them gently towards those targets. Then smooth out transitions so it feels natural and cohesive. There you go, tiny tweaks, huge difference. That's the power of color shaping. It's how your style begins to take shape. Remember these ideas, because next comes the payoff, when everything comes together. Now that your colors are balanced and cohesive, it's time to shape the mood by tinting different tonal zones. Some people use LUTs, plugins, or DCTLs, and that's fine, but you can achieve similar results manually in the free version of DaVinci Resolve, and the concept should work anywhere. There are two main ways to do it. You can use custom curves, which I've covered in details in a previous video. Link is in the description. But for many people, especially beginners, curves can feel a little bit intimidating. So here's an alternative that's more intuitive and surprisingly powerful: lock wheels. Go to the lock wheels interface and focus on the shadows, midtones, and highlight. This is where you can start painting your scene's emotion. Let's say you want to add color contrast but keep the image warm. Start with the midtone wheel. Pull up your factor scope and nudge the color just south of the skin tone line. That adds a natural warmth. Then go to the shadows wheel and push slightly towards the opposite hue, teal in this case. Now push the highlights gently towards yellow. Keep it subtle or go stronger for a stylized look. Now here's the secret most people overlook: adjust the lower and upper ranges. The lower range defines where shadows and midtones separate. The upper range defines where midtones and highlights split. By fine-tuning these, you create clean, elegant separation between each tonal zone. And that's it. You've just built your own color grade from scratch. No LUTs, no plugin. Now you may further polish the grade with your favorite visual enhancers such as halation, glow, grains, and all that jazz, which I've talked about in another video. Before we wrap up, here's a quick bonus tip. Sometimes your image looks harsh or gritty, and that's not because of color. It's the high frequency detail. Think of shooting in the woods or on a busy street. There's texture everywhere, and it can feel overwhelming. A quick fix? In the free version, you can gently lower the midtone detail in the primary color wheels. If you're using the studio version, find Texture Pop in the effect library. It gives you even finer control. Personally, I like keeping some texture for character, so use it very gently. Just enough to polish, not flatten. And that's it. I'll be adding more to this sheet over time, so stay tuned. Leave your questions and comments in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next video.